pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic which stands one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you, everybody, for coming. First item is I'm going to ask the board to go in the other room for the executive session with the intent to return. This one item, review the application, for assessor's office part-time clerk. So we'll be back in about hopefully 5 minutes or less.
Yeah, you need a vote, you need a vote.
I move that we go into the other room based on what.
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Carry.
Now, do you want me to attend?
Yeah.
No, not a problem. No, I can't. Somebody needs to take notes, that's why I'm all in. If you make a decision, you just have to take minutes.
Okay, come on in.
Oh, okay, yeah, no, I have no problem. I have no problem.
Okay, we'll be right back.
No matter what meeting I go to, I have to take the notes.
You can't stick that one for that test, we're pretty slow. Would you like to come in videotape our notes? We'll be right back.
Too bad about Ralph.
It's a whole different thing.
I know.
So.
That's the truth.
Okay.
Hey.
Hi, how are you?
Yeah.
What's your name?
Well, you're right, why don't you be a president? That's a job.
Thanks.
I don't want to get too pushy, but.
Okay, we still want to make a motion when we reconvene the meeting.
So move.
Your second?
Second.
All in favor say aye.
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 I don't want to reconvene, that was a problem.
Okay, the first item is on the agenda. All right, the first item on the agenda is to review the Yiddish Farm Festival application and approve it if the requirements are met. You'll see in your packet that Priscilla put together an entire packet stapled together called the event permit application. If we go through this thing, we have the permit from the Orange County Health Department. Okay. But I do have one question, Dave, on this. It says portable water will be furnished from the village of Goshen.
Right. So originally we were going to have a water truck.
Yeah.
And he was curious about where the water was coming in the water truck, if it was being tested.
Okay.
In the end, since it's going to be such a small festival, we're going to get like big Poland Spring things and fill up
5 gallon jugs?
Yeah, just like 10 gallon jugs. So that's not even going to be an issue.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. The next item is the Form A, which is the from Neil Hollerin's group. It's a site map and whatnot. And Neil has written a note in here that is saying he's okay with it. He has further indicated more sufficient space to comply with the safety concerns I raised during my review. And he talks about the farm itself. But you'll notice that Neil did not sign off on it. Well, I guess he did.
He did.
Okay. He said he wasn't. But, and the reason for it was is the site plan was not to scale. But when you looked at the size of the plot, it's pretty obvious there'll be room, and he spelled out exactly what needs to be done relative to space between the tanks and so forth. Then Chief Marsh has signed off on his. Okay, check the site.
Except he wants to go back on the 13th.
Well, all three of them are going to go back.
That's right, yeah.
On the 13th. The fire department, Jeremy Cohen, has signed off. Okay. We have the certificate of liability, and we have the hold harmless agreement that I have signed along with the applicant. And so anyway, based on the note here from Priscilla, it says the The Yiddish festival permit continued upon inspection by the police department, fire department, and the building office on Wednesday the 13th. Okay. And but other than that, it looks like it's in order. So now she also said essentially the farm adjacent to that, you need to make sure that you have lots of insect repellent.
Oh, I know. Yeah.
Okay, because a lot of mosquitoes and things.
It's a little bit better in the part where we're camping. It's a little more dry, but there are other parts that are, yeah.
Right.
I know about it.
And was it hay?
It was all hay, yeah.
So
we're buying
the
some from it.
Application is the
right. Yeah.
The board got any questions?
I do.
Okay. Good.
I know Phil's been talking about selling food.
Right.
And it says the farm will be selling raw vegetables and grains. Does that require a permit? And I think Phil, we went on list that way. I don't know if that was one of your questions, but
that was
Orange County aware of that, that's all.
Right.
Sure. Yeah, I spoke to John Graziano from the Orange County Health Department. He said if we're not preparing food, basically what happened is we got a donation of vegetables from an organic farm. So, John Graziano knows about it. He said it doesn't require any kind of special permit. He said that we do require the camping permit, which is why we got that.
And I just have one quick question I'd like to know, Phil.
Go ahead.
Under section of Neil Hart, one of the last questions, that's failure to comply with safety and proper maintenance grant may result in prosecution and could result in a fine or imprisonment. Do we have such a provision into this?
Well,
I looked through the board, I didn't see such a provision. If there is, you should be aware of someone shows up to your violation.
He took it out of the comments.
Oh, okay.
He's the code enforcement officer.
Well, that's the case. You have to be aware of that.
I have the same packet.
Right.
Yeah.
That's all I have.
Everything you have, I have also.
Okay.
You had indicated that at the end of the month, you were ending the application process for the attendees and would give us a final count.
Mm-hmm.
Tell us now, on June 30th, what was your final count?
There was a couple of stragglers who had called me in advance. 55 is where it is, where it
okay.
is right now. Yeah.
That's pretty much where.
There's a couple of people that canceled, a couple of people came.
Okay.
55.
55 is what it looks like.
Yeah.
So if we see 500 people there.
If we see 500 people, I'm going to get a bill from Chief Marsh. I know.
Oh, you're going to get more than that.
I'm going to get more than that.
Okay.
Moses may come down from the mountain.
Right, yeah.
there is one question I have, and somewhere probably in here, and that's about food storage. You told us the first time you're talking about
Basically what we've done is we communicated with everyone who's registered, and we split them into smaller groups of 9 people each. And each one of these groups is communicating with each other in advance of the festival, figuring out who's bringing what. You know, one person will bring the coolers, one person can bring a camping stove, one person can bring the pots and pans. That way, not every single person is expected to bring, you know, everything, exactly. So they're responsible for bringing enough food for themselves with coolers, and that's being taken care of by them. We will be providing ice, though. Some of the people coming to the festival are going to be staying in the Days Inn. So the Days Inn agreed that when we drop them off at the hotel, we can pick up ice.
That's good. I'm just looking at the numbers on this thing, the projections, and I can't seem to connect the dots between the amount you have to charge and the amount this is going to cost. And I'm just making an observation. One thing looks like the $4,200 bill for TAM Enterprises just for the portable restrooms and the showers and the standalone wash station.
Right. He hasn't sent me the updated one. The updated one is going to be a lot smaller.
But when I go through all of these, how much is this going to cost? I mean, we're at probably 100, 55 people. You're at $100 a person.
Sure.
Not even, and I don't think that that's anywhere close to what it's going to cost.
Well, our organization received a $4,000 grant to do the festival.
Oh, okay.
Actually, it came in very recently, so it was a big...
So it's not part of this package? Or is it in...
No. It's not, I mean, there's no requirement to talk about how we're funding it. But, we received a $4,000 grant. And then our organization also raised money from individual donors.
Oh, okay.
I mean, it's not, for this year, it's definitely not a moneymaker at all. Not even close. But it's good for our publicity, and it'll be a really fun event. And we're hoping that in the future we can make it more solvent.
Okay.
George?
Unfortunately or fortunately, you were the first person.
I know.
We really tested your spirit.
I feel like we've been through a lot.
You certainly have come through, and I wish you the best as far as the affair. The licensed electrician that you're going to use, who's that?
That's A Plus Mechanical.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. I didn't understand. I assume this is the tent. That's the tent stage, right?
No, that's the stage.
Oh, this is the stage.
Yeah.
So it just said units, carriage, bolted, and tile.
Oh, I attached it in the email.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. The tent itself is a standard one that Orange County Rental provides. I mean, I assume that they're within the code.
I've done a little first aid in my day and stuff like that, and I was very interested to read there that the safe protocol for lightning and thunder is going underneath the tent and position yourself on the top of the mat or sleeping bag.
Mm-hmm.
Is that for real?
That's what I read. I mean,
I looked up
with other
people.
Yeah,
really, website at all, which I didn't actually go to, but I questioned that.
Honestly, I don't think there's much you can do against lightning. So they have to come up with something.
It's become a really big issue.
Well, you know, one of the things, one of the safest places inside an automobile.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, that's with one of the options.
Right. Everyone going to the car,
that's much safer.
Right, now the problem here is that the cars are a little bit far, so I don't know.
On the tent, you're not going to put a lightning rod on top of it on the tent, because electricity always hits the highest points.
Hmm.
So if you put a grounding rod on top of the tent, which you've got a lot of that, a lot of outside concerts.
Oh, yeah.
A lot of them, they're big tall. That's where all the lightning compressors and grounding wires connected.
Sometimes they get canceled.
Yeah, outside concert, touch a wheel.
Ken is a master electrician.
Yeah, the highest point.
It's not very fast.
It's close to the ground. It's about
to have a wire right down to the ground.
I was putting a boom on my sailboat on Friday, and we had a thunderstorm. It was like with 26 feet of mast.
I know the lightning rod. I was like, oh my god! I got off the boat so fast.
Okay,
just
to make sure I'm on.
That's all I
do. It's an inexpensive
box. No, I think you have.
Okay.
I have a couple, but you can keep me to it.
I would like to make a motion then if we authorize this permit for the Yiddish Bar Festival.
I'll make a motion.
Okay, go ahead.
I'll make a second.
Based on the final recommendation on the 13th.
Based on the
fine.
Yeah,
sure.
Oh, yes, this is contingent upon the three
inspections.
Absolutely.
Just
one question.
We have a motion for a second.
Second.
Any discussion? All in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. Now, do you have a question?
Yeah. what happens if they don't show up? Meaning, I'm going to tell them a time when they can come. If it turns out they're doing something else and they don't see this as a big priority and they just don't show up, is that...
Talk about these inspectors.
They'll
be our inspectors.
Oh, they will? Okay.
Our two will be there.
No, I'm saying that there's the fire department and the...
Don't worry about it.
Okay. People.
Don't worry about it.
Okay.
That's our response.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. So, I would like to congratulate you as well, as George, for being the first person to... test this application process.
You need history negotiating.
You also notice there was no application fee this time because we didn't have it in the law on time, but next year, if you do it again, there will be a fee.
What's the fee?
I don't have any idea. That's what you've got to work on.
Okay.
But there will be a fee next year.
Unless you want to make a small donation this year.
Congratulations. Wish you all luck. And the other thing is, if something goes wrong, tell someone. Don't try to...
Right. Then we're more liable.
And I just take action. Okay. Because things do
happen. Oh, I know.
Again, just marking the council can't read, but there's a schedule of fees, which we have.
There
wasn't
any included in the application fee that he filled out, or in the application he filled out.
Okay, I don't know. No. Is Priscilla is aware?
She was aware, and she said she didn't put one down.
Okay, then I can't speak.
I can.
Oh, okay.
Because I talked to her about it.
Oh, okay.
So next year there will be.
Okay.
This year there.
All right.
Okay. Very good, David. Thanks.
All right, thank you very much. I'll send you pictures.
Okay.
All right.
I will.
I'll work hard for it.
And Priscilla's going to send me something, a permit, or I can pick it up.
Oh, she will make sure you get it.
Yeah. Okay. Oh, I went. Okay.
Anyway, her bottom line is that it will not be a charge with this based on what she, the dialogue she had today.
Oh, okay. Oh, that's not a problem. I bet you I spent 30% of my time talking to her about fees. Because she felt very strongly.
Okay, bye. Thank you very much.
That the fees we were proposing at $100 is possibly insufficient. So I don't know how it would have
been. That's all I can say. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, no, I have no problem.
She's not here tonight.
I think she felt actually that the law was not, the new law wasn't enforced.
It
was. Okay. Also, when the police will be reimbursed,
I think what it is that she had not communicated with David all along about fees.
About fees. And
he didn't want to surprise
him. Well, that's fine. It's not going to make or break you, but I know we discussed fees. And I know the fee is part of the local law.
Yes, it is.
Right.
We discussed it. That fee should be 100 based on the
credit. Right. We've been a lot of discussion. Yeah.
Oh, yes. Okay.
Let's move on.
The next item is not ready. The proposed resolution to accept the New York Farms conservation easements on parcel A and parcel B.
That's correct. Just to comment, as I told the supervisor today, they have been informed and requested for additional data. Both Walker, Esposito, and Sweeney, you know, advisor, attorney, and the principal, and they haven't submitted the information yet. Also, the planning board is not ready to sign off on the conditional final approval, so it's premature.
Okay.
So we won't even be doing this on Thursday?
No.
Okay.
No.
We're waiting for them.
Okay. Now, but they do have conditional final.
Kelly Norton told me the map wasn't signed yet.
No, they haven't signed the map, but they have conditional final. They just haven't done all the
conditions.
Right.
Usually a conditional final and that would be signed with the conditions on it.
In this instance, it hasn't been.
The conditional approval is.
Okay, well, I asked Neil, so where is it? Where is it?
Right.
He's, well, they've been given conditional final.
Right.
Okay. But the map hasn't been signed, and they're working on the conditions, so what do I know?
Is Ralph the one that will be signing it?
Correct.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Interestingly enough, I don't want to blame the point, but Kelly Norton told me that the planning board level, that they were substantial information they had to submit yet, and that they had not submitted the map, haven't even requested it be filed or signed. So, compiling data. Yeah.
Okay. The number three, review the proposed resolution to create an expanded Hamiltonian Park Water District, which includes 75 new homes in New York Farms, LLC, for subdivision. Dennis, you want to talk about
that? Yeah, I spoke to the attorney Sweeney today, the attorney for the applicant, and he indicated that they were, quote unquote, treading water at the moment, vis-a-vis the village question.
That wasn't a pond, was it?
No, and that, unintended anyway, and that they would like just to soon see this move along, the creation of the water district. A half a loaf is better than nothing. So he requested that if they had nothing new, nothing, no other proposals, they'd be more than willing to accept the designation and creation of the water district. I indicated to the supervisor that it was inclined by the board, we could do that Thursday evening and by proper resolution. But again, the important or salient point is they are still apparently working with and awaiting the village confirmation that they can hook up sewer-wise. Sewer's the main issue.
Ken, I'm not ready to be under executive session, but one of the requests I sent a written request for authorization. We talked about it again during the negotiation session. They're going to be discussing that at the village board meeting tonight to see if they're going to give us that letter of consent.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll wait and see.
Okay.
So
we're looking at an expanded water district.
Correct.
but an individual, if we don't get the 75, if the village does not give them, or doesn't have the capacity, or for whatever reason, there will not be an expanded sewer district. Is that going to cause any kind of conflict? We have to think about this.
Yeah, no, I had thought about
this. Because if you have a separate sewer district, you'll have a separate water district and you move on. Right?
Correct. And in this instance, they would have to address the sewer in a different manner if, in fact, they cannot hook into the village's plant. And that different manner, I would assume, would be the creation of a sewer plant.
I don't know, I understand that, but once again, in order to create one whole water district, but then you have separate sewer districts, I'm not sure how that would play into each other, because they would be tied hip to hip, but only at one piece.
Well, the reason why this is on here,
subdivision, I just want to make sure that
the reason why this is on here is to highlight to the public and to the two applicants that we're serious about providing water and sewer,
right?
And that, knowing very well we wouldn't do this tonight,
right?
Knowing very well this, we got to wait on this response.
It all hinges on whether they allow these people in or not.
Right.
Right.
So, okay. I think on Thursday night, we will have more information on what to do.
Okay.
But I wanted to highlight to the applicant that we're not the ones that are holding him up.
Right. Okay, good.
In addition, Phil, the board should be aware of that. Engineering-wise, there wouldn't be necessarily a conflict between the creation of a water district and the non-creation of the sewer district.
No, it's not a creation of a water district.
Oh, expansion.
It's an expansion of an existing district.
Right.
I just want to make sure that you know, everything is hinging on what the village does, and I don't want to act out of,
sewer, yes, not water.
We'll
hopefully we'll know what the problem is like that, water and not sewer.
Right, exactly.
And then we'll follow that, that's water and not sewer, right?
Right. Well, those are individual districts, and we could establish
an expansion.
But now we're expanding an existing district.
Because I think there's benefits. According to our engineers.
I think so too.
You know, by definition.
The fact is if we're expanding the water, we'd like to expand the sewer. I guess if we don't expand the sewer, then it goes back to building a sewer plant or some other, whatever it is we got to do.
Correct.
Yeah.
Okay. But anyway, I don't even go there because I don't know what the other options would be.
Okay.
But they did give them approval way back when.
That's been now shut down.
Yeah.
Okay. If we're the ones to create the sewer district, not the village.
I know.
Okay. They gave permission to add the houses.
Yeah.
Then all of a sudden, when they canceled our contract, they canceled the ability of us to add those 75 homes to a sewer district.
Right. I know that.
That's allegedly they canceled it, as I told you.
Whether
they can legally do that is
another reason.
But the point is, we cannot expand the district without them approving the 75 homes. Then we would have to create a separate district for these people. We're going to accommodate them one way or the other because it's a legal subdivision. Right. But the whole thing hinges on, if we expand it, they accept it and say, everybody wins. If we don't, these four people have to go back to square one to do an independent sewer district and see how they're going to do it.
Right.
All right.
I do believe.
Yeah, I was thinking somehow we'd have to move them for county sewer one or two. Village of Florida or Village of Chester. Yeah, I know them all the way.
Okay.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, I think it's going to work its way out.
I hope so.
I think that we had a good conversation in the village, and let's just wait and see.
Okay.
Good. All right. But good discussion. Yeah. The next one, review proposed resolution for Cannon Hill Road dedication. I've talked to Rock Knoll today, Superintendent of Highways. He and Sean Hoffman are going to go look at this again. They did look at it with our planning board attorney. Work needs to be done, and it's just not ready yet to follow up on. And Sean is not at work Friday or today. So,
In addition, some boards where Mako Muffler is out there, and they've been contacted by New Jersey or New York NY Farms in the hopes that they'll also participate in the final dedication cleanup and approval. So that's in the works, but controlled by the Control. It's going through the engineer's office.
Okay.
Dan Drivers.
Is he going to get taken care of then?
I certainly believe it will. I've been pushing him to, as the supervisor knows, because again, it's long overdue, they need to address it.
Good.
Okay, the next thing is discuss and develop a response on behalf of the farmers and the local farm business suppliers to the Federal Wetlands Reserve Program. And this is where Tom Mahookie came in, talked to us. I talked to John Lipinski, who is the Farm Bureau. I've talked to a number of people, and it appears that I think we ought to do something. Now, what the county is doing, I get this piece of paper in here, okay? What the county is, it is a very subtle difference between what the county is going to do and what the town of Warwick did. And I don't know if the county is passed this through the county legislature or not. When you go down to the last, now therefore be it resolved, the county of Orange highly recommends that the federal government, through the office of the NRCS, withhold, withdraw, or rescind the federal funds that have been allocated for Wetland Reserve Program for any land that is suitable for agricultural production. Now that would be here in Orange County. So that one you have where they would say they withhold it. Okay. But if you look at the one from Sweetens Group, they have it. Now therefore it be resolved that the town of Warwick highly recommends the federal government, through the office of the NRCS, withhold, withdraw, or rescind the federal funds that have been allocated for Wetland Reserve Program, period. So in essence, they were saying had nothing, they just wanted to go out of business.
Right.
Where the other one from Orange County says, if the one's allocated for agricultural, or for land that would be suitable for agriculture here in Orange County. I think the one that they have for the Orange County legislature is the way to go.
Yeah, I'm with you.
Okay?
I agree.
And because, not that either one of these are going to be accepted. Okay. Now these then will, if we, you know, what I'm thinking about doing, and the rationale behind this again is, these farmers could be paid $6,000 per acre to pull their land permanently out of agriculture. If they're adjacent to other farmers, that could be devastating on those remaining. And it is very short-sighted. This is a federal program. Probably didn't have any idea about the 12,000 acres of land, farmland in Orange County that this would impact. And there may be versus farmers who would love to take this program. And they may be miffed at us, but you know what? If we're looking at this as a viable business going forward, I think we need to take a stand one way or the other.
I think following the county line, you'd have more success if they were going to rescind part of this rather than just killing the whole thing nationwide. It's like asking for, you know, first degree, the murder rather than second degree. If you don't prove it, then the person walks, you know, and I think it'd be more successful going to county. Because what we're really after is preserving the farmland. That's the name of this. Mm-hmm. Not just killing the whole program for everybody.
Now this would go to Senator Schumer, Senator Gildebrand, Representative Hayworth, and Representative Hinchy, if we pass it. So, are you all kind of in agreement that on Thursday night we come up with a resolution relative to the one that the county's going to do?
I just wanted to one question that I think has been discussed already, but I wanted to make sure I totally understand it as well. One of the concepts is, if in fact this land was sold off and couldn't be used for agricultural purposes in the future, it would go to weeds and potential all sorts of other different types of
trees,
which then, in other words, would jeopardize the so-called good agricultural land.
Right.
Correct.
I
know that's not the only thing.
No, that's right. You're really right on.
One of the things that is, I think it's important to preserve the property that is still going to be used for growing.
It should have come to habitat for rodents, deer, and then even rodents.
And it drops. Especially yeah. important to understand it's directed to the black dirt. I mean, if the black dirt is taken out of production, there's no other viable use. You can't build on it. You can't locate a facility on it or a structure. Well, unlike upland or gray soil.
Well, the Fish and Wildlife would love this to happen. Because they wanted to go back to Mother Nature.
That's something different.
And, but that's not, this one is, but the remaining farmers, the ones who are going to problem is the drainage ditches that will fill in, mm-hmm. silt in. It is wildlife, as Kenny just said, the deer and the other rodents.
I would think.
All the seeds, the weed seeds and things will blow on. So it'll make remaining adjacent farming very difficult.
Right.
Okay? Mm-hmm. So we'll put this on for Thursday night, and we'll just kind of
do you want a resolution on it, Doug? We're going to have one. I just know whether you want to prepare it, the counties, or you want me to.
I think so.
I'll prepare it in textual form.
Okay.
Yeah. And just add 2 cents into it. I went to a meeting 2 years ago over in Warwick. The reason I think Warwick wanted to stop completely because they faced a problem. I went to that the federal government want to take wetlands from New Jersey and flood out their farmlands up in Warwick.
Yeah.
And I went, so that's probably why Warwick took a little serious. They have different problems. So they want all stops to protect their farmlands. And the government want to flood some lands from Northern Jersey over to Warwick.
Okay.
That's a big meeting.
Bottom line is, I don't know if the federal government's going to respond to this or not, but I think we can go on record saying we're trying to protect the land.
There's been a bunch of meeting tonight.
Yeah, knowing that black dirt is going for between $1,500 and $2,000 an acre, there'll be a lot of people responding to this.
Yeah, sure.
Well, yeah.
I go buy some equipment, you know.
And they have no reason to preserve the land. It's good for nothing else.
I know.
They would take the funds, walk away, and we'd have some more land on the tax roll.
Shotgun approach to another issue.
It's wasted.
Washington's a long way from Orange County.
Yeah, sure.
Okay.
They have bigger problems, too.
Oh, yeah.
Right now, I think.
Okay, good. You want to talk about this next one?
Okay, here it is. Discussion, develop, response, and we have to frankly, we had talked about this a couple of weeks ago, and I thought we had made a motion to do it, to hire the two-part-timers, but not by names.
No.
Oh, not
we
by
had,
names.
No,
just by positions. Oh, okay.
Yeah. This has got the positions.
But I did explain their qualifications, the two people.
Right.
One had Coast Guard and one had gone through the academy. They both gone through the academy. Paid their own way. I thought we know this.
We didn't have the way to pay, nor did we have their name. So.
Okay.
We had to pay by contract,
though. Yeah. We had to put in the motion.
Okay.
So. Would someone like to make a motion? We can hire any part-time off of Gene and Ann Newsy and Jeremy Marciello. Effective July 12, 2011, at a rate of $21.30 per hour.
So moved.
Is there a second?
Second.
Any discussion?
I have a discussion that I'd like to put into executive session, actually, about one of the individuals. And I'd like to discuss that with the board before this is approved.
All right. So I'd like to table this motion then.
You've got a motion on the floor.
Yeah.
I wonder if we can table it Thursday night after executive session. I can say tonight. Also, I have another meeting tomorrow night, which I can get further information on. So
I just hold off until. The date, so we need to withdraw that motion, right?
Yes. You have to correct.
Tomorrow is the date.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
All right. Who made the second?
I withdraw
my motion.
Thank you.
And Raymond?
We'll need this on
Thursday
night.
That should be added on to the executive session as far as personnel, please.
Yep.
ED, please.
On the set.
Yeah, because I won't be here for this.
Okay. But that's valuable input. The next thing is we have a request for the Tour de Goshen annual race. It's being planned for August 21st. 2011. See, it's from Dr. John Carey. They'd like permission to do this.
Hello.
funds, the profits will go to the Winslow Therapeutic Center. And he said the route will be going through your municipality. We appreciate your support as you have provided in the past. I don't remember exactly what we did in the past. Is anybody?
Yeah, they provide them insurance.
Yeah. No, I was talking about that we just had with a 5K race with the chamber. Do we provide anything beyond our normal piece?
Nothing. I
don't know. No, years ago, they staff have set up.
Okay.
Right. Just control our regular.
Yeah. Would someone like to make a motion regarding this story?
So moved.
I'll second it.
Any discussion?
Yep. Okay. Dennis, this is really for you, more I guess than anybody else, but I was really interested in the language that is on the certificate of liability insurance. And it basically states here, the certificate holder is included as additional insured where required by written contract on the lines of the portfolio, but only to the extent bodily injury or property damage is caused in whole or in part by the acts or omissions of the insurer.
Mm-hmm.
Is that, if that
yeah.
to me seemed like they were carving out and possibly placing some liability back on us?
It's an attempt, if you want to think of it that way. But what they're really saying is that their insurer, which is the Rotarian Club, is the insurer, and if the negligence or injury is a result of the acts, part or whole, of those people or anybody associated with them, coverage is going to be bound.
Right.
But if, for instance, some unassociated person, a criminal act, some other organization, some person totally unrelated to the event causes an accident or results in personal injury, they would not respond to that.
Mm-hmm.
Right. So it's a limitation, if you will,
yeah.
of the insurance coverage they're providing.
Yeah, so although it didn't happen with the Tour de Rocha, there was one that I think we all remember where the car slammed into a biker.
Right, they would argue they would be excluded from that coverage.
Right, so then the lawsuit then naturally would be between that car and all this stuff. But let's say they have no insurance or something, it's going to come back onto the
town. It would.
Back onto
right.
So then what I would be requesting, I think, is that I have never seen this language in any other insurance certificate that we have seen.
Yeah, it's an attempt by them.
So what I would like to do is to say, yeah, it's fine in order,
but
delete that.
Purposely well taken. But what it has to do with is exposure or risk. Because of the activity, the company is taking the position that, look, if an act, either a commission or mission, part or whole, is by someone involved in the event, insurance will cover.
Yeah,
disinsurance.
But look at that. That's a very small percentage.
Yes.
Of things that could happen.
Absolutely. It's an effort for them to limit their exposure or risk in the event of some accident, totally unrelated to.
What would we want in here?
Just the exclusion.
Just
George
take
says,
it all in.
Take it out.
The other one that we had. It had no language,
right?
Or it did have some language, but it wasn't anything.
So
yeah,
we want to. Withdraw the
can you make an amendment to it?
No, what you'd have to do is notify.
Well, no, that's what I think. What I'm thinking between now and Thursday, we can notify Dr. Carey to get
right.
this taken out.
Yeah.
So in the meantime, and we do it Thursday night, we can get it done
with
right.
So who made the
motion? I'll withdraw the motion.
Okay, who seconded it?
No. I'll withdraw my second.
Okay.
Hey,
George, this wasn't like this last year, was it?
No.
You know, I don't remember.
I don't believe so. No.
To tell
this
you
is,
the truth. But
you're starting to see more and more of this because the insurance companies are, you know.
So just should explain it wasn't that way
yeah,
last year.
That would be my understanding.
Yeah.
It wasn't.
So he knows.
But even if it was, I would take a position that the town.
Not good enough.
Exactly. The town wants to be protected. And that exclusion or limitation is not acceptable.
Right.
Regardless of what was done last year or the year before.
Well, I'm just going to make it easier.
It might make it easier, but then I think it just requires me to check it.
Well, you want me to follow up with Dr. Carey? Yeah. Okay, cool.
All right.
Don't worry, George.
And plus, of course, you know that can be done rather quickly. One phone call, they'll either do it or not.
They'll probably charge a $300 form for the policy.
That's something different.
Okay, very good. George is going to manage that.
Okay.
Okay, the next item we have a resolution. Again, Phil, you want to go through that one?
Yes, so each year we have a grant for the DWI program. They paid for two officers to go and do DWI stops and so on and so forth. So we have to sign a new contract. It's just extending the original contract. But we've had this every year, and it's a very, very good program, as a matter of fact, with no cost to the town. So we need to sign have a resolution so that Chief Marsh can sign the second half of this contract.
Okay. Would you like to make a motion in regard to this resolution?
I'll make a motion.
Second? Any discussion? Madam Clerk, may we roll call vote, please?
Supervisor Bloomfield.
Aye.
Councilman Capella.
Aye.
Councilman Lyons.
Aye.
Councilman Santorino.
Aye.
Councilman Rubel.
Aye.
Motion carries. Thank you very much.
Just want to add that the DW report is a great, but it also results in sometimes a very serious arrest. They will pull someone, maybe a felony warrant or something. So doesn't prevent DWI, which is tremendous, get them off the road.
Right.
But sometimes that will be, and another result to you.
It's an opportunity to take a second look, and we don't have to pay for those extra patrols.
Great program.
It's a great program. It is. It really is.
Okay. Does anybody else have any for the general meeting? Okay, would someone like to make a motion to go into executive session with the intent not to return to discuss the PDO officer candidates for part-timers, status update of New York DOT request for release of preferential acquisition rights, status update on the sewer IMA negotiations with the village, discuss response to Mayor Roddy's letter canceling the sewer contracts with the town, discuss Eastgate tax sharing, discuss the legal case of Conant versus the town of Goshen, and Sedarovic tree trimming. Okay.
And then
there's one, I'm going to call it update on Operation Yellow.
That would not be sufficient.
No.
That's all I can say about it.
CIA negotiations?
Not proper.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. It has to be fall into one of the categories. You know, yeah. Personnel, litigation, contract, negotiations.
Negotiations.
Can you at least indicate with whom?
A future business.
Oh, okay. Okay, that's fine.
Okay.
I assume it's a future business, just considering locating a Goshen.
That's correct.
That's fine.
Right. Okay. Thank you. Great clerk.
I would want CIA.
Okay. I'd like that.
Oh, FBI. I'm doing FBI.
Okay.
Does anybody else have any for the
I'm going to watch TV.
He's got the TV.
Okay, any other items for
since I've been reading a lot of kids' books lately,
it
reminds me of what's his name, the monkey in the Man in the Yellow Hat.
I can tell you this much out of school. I get a call at mid-afternoon. Can you be at a certain location at 6:15 regarding an operation?
Yeah.
Somebody used that to you?
Yeah. So tell me a little bit more about it than I did, but very little.
Okay.
So I went.
So
is there a second?
I'm not sure. Any discussion?
All in favor say aye.
Aye.
What do you guys have for dinner?
We just haven't finally done.
I know you're full of change, guys.